Good morning, everyone. This is Shyam, Assistant Professor, Civil Department, Chebrol Engineering College. Subject is Geotechnical Engineering 1, Unit 1. On topic, Compaction of Soils. Compaction of soil increases in the strength and its characteristics of soils, which increase the bearing capacity of foundations constructed over them. Compaction also decreases the amount of undesirable settlement of structures and increases the stability of slopes of embankments. The purpose of compacting soil. The first purpose is increased shear strength. This means that larger loads can be applied to compacted soils since they are typically stronger. Increased shear strength, it is equal to increased bearing capacity, slope stability and pavement system strength. And next purpose is the reduced permeability. This inhibits soil's ability to absorb water and therefore reduces the tendency to expand and shrink and potentially liquefy. And third one is the reduced compressibility. This is also means that larger loads can be applied to compacted soils since they will produce smaller settlements. And next one, controls swelling and shrinking. And next purpose of compacting soil, reduce liquefaction and potential. The compaction in general in this densification of soil by removal of air, which requires mechanical energy. Simplistically, compaction may be defined as the process in which soil particles are forced closer together with the resultant reaction in air voids. Principles of compaction. Compaction of soils is achieved by reducing the volume of voids. It is assumed that the compaction process does not decrease the volume of solids or soil grains. Here, figure different portions shows. First one, soil before compacted. It is loosely. And here provide air gaps. And next one, compacted the soil. And here air gaps are collapsed. In another diagram formed soil before compacted and after compacted soil particles or solids. Principles of compaction. It is compaction effect. Loose soil and compacted soil. Here loose soil in solids, water, air formed. It is the phase diagram and convert into compacted soils. Solids, water and air. Here solids and water is formed same portions and air is decreased in compacted soils. the degree of compaction of a soil is measured by the dry unit weight of the skeleton. The dry unit weight with the degree of dragging of soil grains, gamma d equal to gamma w into gs divided by 1 plus c, where gamma w unit weight of water and gamma d is dry density weight, g is the specific gravity, e is the void ratios. The more compacted soil is, the smaller its void ratio will be, the higher its dry unit weight gamma d will be. Compaction curve. The compaction curve is the relation between soil water content and dry unit weight. Soil sample was computed at a different water contents in a cylinder of volume 1000 cc, cc means cubic centimeters, and dry unit weight were obtained. Here dry weight is indicated gamma d equal to gamma by 1 plus wc. The water w is the water content. Compaction curve is plotted between the water content and dry density of ordnance. It is the curve of compaction. X axis in water content and y axis the dry unit weight. It is indicated gamma d and water content is wc. It is observed that the dry density increases with an increase in water content till the maximum. Density is attained with a further increase in water content. The dry density decreases. Here show the graph. In x-axis water content, increase the water content, and y-axis in dry density, dry unit weight or dry density, it is increases and slowly decreases of unit weight. Then finally increase the water content and dry density is decreases. It is the compaction curve. The compaction curve in optimum moisture content. The curve is x-axis in water content and y-axis in dry unit weight. The water content corresponding the maximum dry unit weight, it is called optimum moisture content. Note that maximum dry unit weight is only maximum for a specific compactive effect and method of compaction. Here water content is increases and dry unit weight is increases certain point, maximum point, that is the dry unit weight gamma d maximum, and after dry unit weight is decreases, then water content corresponding to maximum dry unit weight, it is called optimum moisture content. Here optimum moisture content, each compactive effect for given soil has its own OMC. OMC means optimum moisture content. As the compactive effect is increased, the maximum density generally increases and OMC decreases. Here water content and dry unit weight, x-axis y and y-axis. So gamma d maximum 1 at OMC 1, optimum moisture content and OMC2 optimum moisture content to at dry density YD maximum to. The maximum density generally increases and optimum moisture content is decreases. And compaction curve at zero air voids curve or saturation line. The curve represent the fully saturated condition. Fully saturated is indicated to S. Fully means 100%. So S equal to 100%. It cannot be reached by compaction theoretically unit weight. It is given gamma D equal to gamma W into GS divided by 1 plus WC into GS. Here gamma W is unit weight of the water. GS means specific gravity. WC is the water content and GS specific gravity. So gamma D is the unit weight, dry unit weight or dry density. Here water content is x-axis and dry density also y-axis. Here optimum moisture content OMC, YD maximum. Here compacted fully saturation, then air voids is zero, then saturation is 100%. So soil is fully compacted. Next line of optimums in compaction curve. A line run through the peak points of several compaction curves at different compactive effects for the same soil will be almost parallel to zero air voids curve. It is called the line of optimums. So here different compactive effects means dry unit weights increases some points at certain points and different optimums. All maximum points connected to the line of optimums. And here fully saturated, then zero void rates. It is almost parallel line to all optimums. Then it is called line of optimums. So here see the dry unit weight and certain points.